Hey team, Andre from High Performance Academy. Welcome along to another one of our webinars where I just wanted to quickly touch on an Instagram that we put up just recently. And this is Intercooler Design. And not every intercooler, unfortunately, is made equal. The reason I want to touch on this is because this one's quite close to my heart because I've been caught out by this a couple of times with customer cars in the past. It's very easy from the outside to look at a Chinese or Taiwanese intercooler core that's 600 by 300 by 76, kind of the industry standard sort of entry level intercooler, and think, well, yeah, that's going to do the job. Unfortunately, what's really important is what's on the inside in terms of these internal fins here. And this provides surface area for the heated charge air to contact, to transfer heat out of the air into the aluminium, where it can then be transferred through the aluminium to the atmospheric or ambient air outside. Now, I did come across a range of intercoolers that were coming into New Zealand from one of the Chinese suppliers, and it looked like they'd changed their tooling, and we ran one of these intercoolers on a car, and it just made no power, and the intake air temperatures were stratospheric, absolutely ridiculous, even at moderate boost. After we kind of deduced what the problem was, looking into the core, I unfortunately don't have a photo of it to show you in comparison. This, by the way, that we're looking at right now is a plazmaman core, and this is what we should be seeing. But in comparison, this core was basically just about bare. You could just about see straight through it. There was little to no finning, basically no area for the air to contact to dissipate that heat. And the result was the intercooler just couldn't do its job. It couldn't get rid of that intake temperature. Because it was that generic 600 by 300 size, we swapped with this particular car while it was still bolted to my dyno with one that we had in stock that had a proper internal fin design. I can't remember specifically, but I think at the same boost pressure, we picked up something in the region of about 40 or 45 kilowatts at the wheels. It was a massive improvement for just changing the intercooler. So just something to keep in mind. I'm not saying you have to go out and buy brand name intercoolers. These are obviously guaranteed, but there are some good quality cheaper intercoolers out there. Might not perform quite as well as the top dollar brand name, but just make sure you understand what you're actually purchasing, and a quick look through the side of the core there to make sure it's got that internal finning is going to sort you out and make sure that you don't come up short with increasing intake air temperatures and a lack of power.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.